Howdy, everybody! Welcome back to... I don't know what this is, actually. We need to give it a name. What should we call this? Sorry, I'm just going to pick up this because I've accidentally toppled that over. So you might remember, not too long ago, we checked out a video where a guy who goes by Swish now, just changed when we did the video, didn't he? He impersonated me in the aisle, and I thought I would do a video reacting to it. He said, at 1,000 subscribers, he was going to impersonate himself, which was kind of just a joke. So, but he didn't have 1,000 subscribers. There you go, he's on 1.87 there, then we did it! Yeah, we did it! We're changing lives here on the Game Beaver channel. So in response, he decided to record some aisle and edit it like it was a Game Beaver video. And actually, after that video went live, when we reacted to the fake one, he live streamed. he live streamed him watching, reacting to me, reacting to him. It was weird.
Beaver! No way. Beavers in the street. That's crazy. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I'm freaking out right now.
Something I've always like prided myself on is my editing. I know, right? It's stupid. Like, I've tried in the past to get editors to sort of fill in because it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work. If you edit it, you can, you know, record it, edit it, do thumbnail, everything. If you do it all by yourself, that's why like there's a lot of the big YouTubers have editors. So this is like, I'm gonna see this as an application. Can he actually mimic my editing style? So without further ado, let's see if I would hire him and be like, yeah, you wanna edit my videos? There you go, let's do this. All right, starting with welcome Mr. T-Rex, I think it is, from The Lost World, PlayStation 1 with the coming up.
My bike just go right through?
Look, yeah, this is great. I saw this. Great.
And I approve of this message.
That's really good.
There is a Spinosaurus. I kind of want to follow him and see where he goes.
Ah, see, first thing, zoom in, I cut the audio. I cut it so you focus on the voice, but already Primordial Forest from the same soundtrack. Very well done, very well done. What's that font? That's that one.
No, you idiot, don't do that.
All I can say is I miss Legacy. And honestly, like, Avrima's one thing, but like, I'm really, really going
Jeopardy
to miss
think music.
Legacy when it's
That's
going
another
to
one.
Because honestly,
okay, zoom in, you need to cut.
This is the version of the aisle that all the memories are from.
We need to focus on the farts, burps, and snorts. Brilliant, love it. We've got more Lost World soundtrack. If I remember right, this is Sulphur Fields? Oh, I'm so sorry, James. I thought it was Sulphur Fields. But if we play Sulphur Fields... No, that was wrong. I always get these two mixed up. It's actually the King's Lair. That's it. Ah, oh, you were so close.
Eggs.
Well.
Okay.
I mean, no real reason for that to be in there, but I think it was just like, let's get all the memes in. Where's the eggs at?
That's pretty scary. I'm gonna run over to the Avebody. I'm gonna take one last bite. I'm gonna get a drink of water, and then I'm gonna head to Great Falls.
Actually, something that he's done is increase the brightness and the contrast, because the icons on the bottom right are really bright. And that's something that I do that I don't think people realize, is that I just bump up the brightness, because when it becomes night, it's super dark.
How did I run past that? Heck.
Yeah, the split second meatball parade. Yes, very well done.
I just realized, guys, this couldn't possibly be a beaver video because I spawn in a daytime. Beaver never spawns in a daytime.
Well, true. Actually, what I do is I go onto a server, and if it's night nowadays, I just wait. I just go, exit, go to another server. See, you made a mistake here. This is Family Guy's Play Me Off Johnny. I used to put this in videos until I was copyright struck. There was a spat, there was a little short period of time in YouTube's history where random companies could copyright claim on the behalf of somebody else. And that's what happened with all these like 2 second snippets. And I think YouTube put in something that needs to be a 5 second snippet now for it to be claimed. So we're just gonna skip past this for a second. There we go.
Big spiky rock coming out of the ground.
Swish, I hope you're taking notes, because I might hire you after this.
Oh, a giga. Okay. Yeah, this isn't funny anymore. I am not doing that. Okay.
I very rarely watch aisle videos, so it's weird not knowing what's gonna happen next.
Just gotta crouch right here.
Oh, he is! Oh! Is he got- what are you running towards him for? I mean, is there anything you can do? Ah, nice! You died from Dark Souls. Well done. He's getting a lot in here. That's the fourth use of Primordial Forest. I wouldn't use it that many times. When you're using music a lot, people pick up, or at least I pick up on like certain note keys, so they're which is the start of Primordial Forest. So either what I do is I'll take a different segment and then crossfade that with something else, or I'll just use a different soundtrack entirely. Because if I keep on hearing that da-da-da-da, I start to be like, getting a bit fatigued. It's like music fatigue. You start to hear the same thing over and over. I'm sure there's gonna be people like, I do and I hate it.
If anyone comes by that is small enough for you to eat.
This Primordial Forest is very like, you're just a small thing. It's all fun and games. Whereas this seems like that what's happening right now isn't something that's all like, oh yeah, it's all holly jolly fun. You're kind of out in the open, you could be hunted by something. It doesn't give off the Primordial Forest feels to me that the music would give. I would go something for like, if you're using the same soundtrack, Dinosaur Graveyard would be a good one here. Something that's it's quite low, but there is a little tense atmosphere to it with little peaks of audio, like instruments. That's what I would go for there. God Ray sound or Heaven's Choir. Very well done.
Okay, yeah, no. Those are
what
Delos.
Are those?
I'm Delophosaur. Going to be absolutely nowhere near that. I'm going to come over here. I'm going to sit in the bush.
You see, at that point, I would have changed the music. Because you still got that. Da, 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 da. You're about to be killed. We're not like. Ah, la, la. We go for suspense. We go for. And change it to like.
Yes. In the bush.
Or at least for me, it's like, no, please don't kill me. I'm just used to being killed, it's a joke.
And completely ignore that.
Just cut it.
Thing. What are they eating?
What the? Oh, is I have mentioned right in one video, I definitely edited rock because I mentioned rocks and I put rock in, but I did the Oreo thing, so I think that's. Oh, he's eating Oreos. I think this is that edit, but the version of the rock nutrients. But I love that sometimes it's just like, cut the music. That hard cut is so... It's so like, what the hell just happened there? For my ears and for the screen, like, if I cut audio, it's either on a zoom in or a zoom out. Because then something's happened. It's like, but when it just cuts, it's like, did I miss something?
And now that they are gone, I get up. Oh, okay, that's a Subrex. Now that they're gone.
You see, now this is to be an interesting part, right? Because all these audio, all these soundtracks and stuff, they all have like different parts that crescendo. And we're about to enter like a very intense moment in the music. What is it just gonna play the intense music or is something gonna happen? This is interesting. Because I know these soundtracks in the back of my head, like all the way through. So it'd be interesting to see what happens. Is it just gonna play normally or is something gonna happen?
I get up and leave like nothing ever happened. Yep. Nothing ever happened.
Nope.
Oh
nope,
my
nothing.
Gosh, that's a Carno. That's an adult Rex. Alright, so we're gonna go this way. And there's like this little waterfall over here.
Maybe something did happen.
Okay, and this is our sanctuary. This is where we will camp out. And
whoa, how do you find that music? No, I like not the wow, but this theme right here.
Hide from any monsters trying to munch our heads off. Check it out.
I'm curious, Swish, how did you find that? The only reason I know of this is there was when I used to stay over with my grandparents when I was a little kid. Every morning they would listen to this radio show called The Archers. So I would always hear this like, like theme tune. Because I've had people in the past who have like emulated or taken things from my videos, like The Laughing Policeman being one of them. And I'm like, oh, how did you know about The Laughing Policeman? And they never respond, like, oh, they just took it. Like they took the audio sample from my video and then put it in their video. Didn't know what the hell it was. So I wonder if he knew that this was the from the radio show The Archers, or if he was just like put his phone up to what is this song?
It's even got a pool. Comes with a pool. This is my resort.
Diet Docks. This is very
Swish,
good, very
Swish
good.
Resort and Co. Yeah.
One eternity later.
Oh, SpongeBob transition. Good, good, good.
Dinner time, everyone.
The audio in the game is a little bit too loud from your voice. Like, that waterfall is deafening.
You know, get my exercise.
Just whenever he's in the water, get that Diet Docks on there, Co. He deliberately did this. He was like, okay, right, he's got a checklist. This guy's got a checklist of like, okay, we need to include the eggs, we need to include the die dogs. Okay, like, let's get a swimming footage. I love it.
I see it. He's right.
See, there it is. Da-da-da-da. Just like, we're back to the beginning again. We're back to the beginning of Primordial Forest. So now, in my head, I'm like, okay, so for the next God knows how long, we're gonna have da-da-da-da-da-da-da. But that's like 5 times I've played that song, no more.
Oh, no.
It's not the same sound effect over and over.
In the water, because if I go in the water, I'll be able to eat him. Come on, get out of the water. Yeah, run.
What?
Okay. You're so fast.
See, that would have been a point where you could have done.
Now we're gonna go check out this area. What is this?
This is great. This is because whenever I record the aisle, hours and hours and hours worth of footage or whatever it is, there's always like a stress or like a fatigue I feel because I know that at some point I'm gonna have to go through all of it and add all these edits in. But this is almost like seeing a previs version, like a first draft. And I'm like, okay, so make that change there. Put that. This is great. I don't have to do anything.
No, leave me alone. Let's make it our life's mission as an aloe.
I thought it happened again there.
To go back to Great Falls, find that Giga and murder him. Not that Giga, because I don't want to go against that Giga until I'm fully grown. And even when I'm fully grown, I don't think I want to go against that Giga. I was just saying that for content, and I don't think I'm going to get content out of that, because I'll probably die if I try to get content out of that, because it's a Giga and I'm an aloe.
But that's content! You dying is content! But hold on! Between you being a young aloe and this aloe, you must have cut hours of footage! Or something! What happened? Oh, sorry, my bad. What usually happens in my aloe videos? Nothing.
I'm good.
Again, I feel like he's just left the primordial forest on like autoplay. So what's happening right now? Him sneaking, being like wary of the Giggers. And then like the orchestra in the background's like la 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 la. It's like, oi! Stop it! That, I'm so happy, go lucky me. Used to get copyright struck for that as well, that same theme. The same reason I got struck by the Play Me Off Johnny. So that's why you no longer hear I'm so happy, happy, go lucky me, or Play Me Off Johnny, because I think it was in both, and I like they were both in Isle videos and they got struck, and that was before I could appeal it. So even now, if that happens in a video, I can mute it, but I can't go back to the old video that it's happened in and change it. So I have like 2 Isle videos that are unmonetized or demonetized because of this reason. So frustrating, but it only comes with experience though.
That might just fell off like a mountain. What are you talking about?
There we go, there we go. And most people remember the zoom ins. Not many people remember the zoom outs though. I like that call.
Oh.
Whoa, hold on. What was that sound effect you used for the, that should be a Link Wind Waker Hurt sound effect, is it? I don't think it was Wind Waker, but it might have been Ocarina of Time, Young Link. So very close.
Made food bad.
Oh, what's this one? Is this the Plains? Is this, it's still the compy level from the PlayStation 1 game, but I think this is the Plains. I don't often use it, or it might be under the water, I think.
Chrono's looking to eat. I want to go get that dead body. That is something I.
This is more like a thinking music.
I was gonna go out the baby theory, but
I find.
I mean, being being this small.
And a lot of the times with this soundtrack, what I'll do is because it has at the start of the soundtrack, it's very like pondering, is something gonna happen, and then it does kind of cliche, I don't know what you would call a crescendo. It's kind of an end. Anyway, it gets louder and more intense. And what I usually do is take the first segment of that and copy paste that a couple of times, and then crossfade it in a way that doesn't make it obvious that it's constantly looping.
Like, I'm not fully grown adult. I don't think I would be able to get past.
Let's see what he
trick.
Does.
And I would die from just one horn shot. I need food.
See, it's coming.
I'm going over here.
Coming.
I'm going to get.
Here we go. It's coming.
One of those bodies.
You can hear it. Bum, 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 bum.
Okay. Oh. Powder, no, that's not.
Yeah, it's definitely one of my videos.
man. Get your big boy shant.
Oh, we got Lair of the King going now. That should have been a... That's what that should have been. You got bit by Utah. Is this how he's gonna die?
World.
Not so friendly anymore.
Is he trying to log out? Oh, he must be starving. What is with these Utahs? He comes running towards them, and the one he's chasing runs away, but the other ones just stand there and get bit. What's going on? There you go, see? That's a problem with an edit there. So the whole soundtrack played, and most of these soundtracks end with a crescendo, and it just sort of fades out. So what you need to do is you need to go further into the soundtrack and further into the new soundtrack and then merge them together that way rather than the end and the beginning, or else it's quite easy to hear that loop. As a viewer, it sort of sucks you out. It's like, wait, what's happening? And, or for me anyway, I don't know if it's that way for you guys. So if you just listen to this music crescendos and goes out and then da-da, it comes back in. And at this point, I think the viewer realizes, oh, it's the same soundtrack. Oh, I know what to expect. It's gonna all happen again. And at that point, I don't know, you're sort of taking out what's happening in the actual video, and you're thinking, you're focusing more on the soundtrack. And really, the soundtrack should just complement what's happening on the screen. Does any of this make sense? Like, or is it just my head, and that's how I think of editing?
Carry on, shall we?
The third time, keep that same soundtrack going. He's merged this one out later, so I think you only need a little bit extra, and he's just got the end of the soundtrack and then put that bit in. Am I right? God, this battle lasts a long time. Oh, did he die? Do we not get that died one? Just died off screen. Well, that's not satisfying.
All right, everyone. Well, that was it for today's video. Hope you guys did enjoy. But yeah, guys, that was a pretty fun video to make. The end was a little weird, you know. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching.
The end was a little weird, you know. Anyway, guys, thank you so much. Primordial Forest again for the outro. And my beaver logo, you could have just ripped that from the video. There wasn't enough Microsoft, Sam.
I know. I'm the best part about these videos.
But yeah, I think that was a really good effort. That was really, really good. There's definitely a few things, of course, you know, it's me saying it, that could have made it more of my style. But 100%, that's probably been the closest I've seen anybody replicate that. And I would say that was a really, really good replication. Okay, I'm excited for this one. Now, we're obviously not gonna watch the full thing. If you want to watch the full thing, I'll link it in the description below. When this first came out, I wanted to do a reaction to it because, of course, I like dinosaurs and I did animation. When did this come out? When was it? 2019, so yeah. Oh my God, it was like 2 years ago now. I mentioned to the guy, I was like, oh, I might do a reaction to this. Do you have any problem with it? He was, oh, no. And I think he mentioned that he had some prints of it that he wanted to sign and give away. I don't know if he still has those. Oh, is it Mattel? Yeah, it is Mattel Indoraptor model that you can just buy. This would be really interesting. Oh, that's beautiful. That's really good. Oh my God. Oh wow, this is like, I'm assuming as well that he's moving the camera each frame little bit by little bit. Like it's not on like a dolly or anything. Okay, so I'm assuming this is a dream then. The Indoraptor cut the fuse box! Or not, because the TV is actually still working. Hey. There she is! There he is! Oh, now all the lights come back on. Ha ha! I just wanted to watch the movie. How did he get it to move like that? Magnets? Because this was one of the main selling points for the toy, was like, oh, it has all these points of articulation. I like the stomping sound effects from JPOG. Yeah, I've done enough animating in my time to recognize those. It's like my only library I had access to when I was a kid was like the JPOG sound effect library. When I did animations. I like this. Is this whole thing on a turntable? This is awesome. This is the thumbnail. I recognize this shot. Here's Indy. Oh, that's cool. That's cool. The pizza's arrived! The sound effect. Bum, 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 bum. That's all it wanted was the pizza. And it was all a dream. Watch it be the Indoraptor with the little, like, delivering the pizza. That's what the twist will be. He does have magnets at the bottom. Ah, oh, Mason, you did a really good job. Special thanks to Ted Brothers for the custom Mattel Indoraptor repaints. Oh, nice. I was wondering, it didn't look like Indoraptor straight from Mattel. It looked a little bit different. You didn't add like the Indoraptor to be the delivery pizza guy? Ah, oh, you missed out on a trick. Oh, well, there you go. That was awesome. Well done. I can't believe it took me 2 years to finally get around to see that. I know there's some other dinosaur animations that people have wanted me to watch. Bear with me, guys. You see, I searched shark. This is kind of like, I don't know. I don't know. I saw this the other day and I was like, I need to include this somehow because I feel like people have a misunderstanding when it comes to nature. It was followed by something else I've watched. So, basically, there's this nutcase of a woman. It turns out she's Australian. Who'd guessed? And she basically hand feeds a freaking great white shark. Okay, let's just watch it. Let's watch it.
And he came right up to the platform, took my fish. And he looked at me. And I said to Ron, I think I might be able to hand feed him. And Ron said, I think we can.
What's your name? You're staring down this huge mouth, looking at you. I think I might be able to hand feed him. Yes, go for it. Just die. Oh, let's keep going. You're a nutter.
I just put my fish in the water and I'd call out, come on, Sharky, come on, come on. And come up, put his head out of the water. Take the fish, pet his nose, and go away.
This is the problem. I think she pets him here. Is she pet? So, first off, great whites aren't murderers like Jaws thinks they are, or made you believe they are. What Jaws did for sharks was horrendous, absolutely bad. Sharks were killed, hunted, basically just because of that film, they were seen as man-eaters. But the problem we have as human beings is there are also other people who see them as pets. It's just got in their head like, oh, I've got a relationship with this shark. Like, it knows me. It's relaxed. I can do anything I want with it. It's relaxed because it's being basically fed. It's not having to hunt or anything like that. And there's a point, hold on, she needs to say something else. Wait for it.
I feel that the shark and I had an understanding. Because at any time, he could have risen from the water and taken me. White sharks do this very well.
It didn't want to do that because you were basically hand feeding it. Why would it expend energy doing that?
If circumstances had been different, I could have got in the water and swum with the shark and done that.
What do you mean circumstances would be any different? Go in? The water's right there. I don't understand where this came from.
I had a feeling it wouldn't bite me. Now, most great whites, I don't have a feeling like that at all. This one, I had a feeling for. I had started to understand when you'd be able to work with a shark.
Yes, I'm sure that's the reason why you keep moving your feet away from it.
I get a feeling about an animal. I can't explain it. It comes from inside. I like you. I think we can get along very nicely.
The problem is, these are wild animals, right? And of course they're gonna act differently depending on the environment, what's happening, if they're hungry, yada, yada, yada. There's a plethora of factors that determine how a wild animal reacts. The problem is, that Jaws made the general population believe that sharks are killers, murderers, hunters, man-eaters, when they're really not. They're just, like most creatures, just going about their daily lives, eating what they do. But at the same time, then you have the other end of the spectrum of people who think, you know, oh, we have an understanding, we can do this and that. For instance, there was a guy, I can't remember what he was called, he called himself the Grizzly Man. For 13 years, he went to Alaska and camped out there with the grizzly bears, saying that they were misunderstood because of Jaws and because of other news events and stuff. People do have a misconception with animals and think that they are killers when they're not. They're just animals going about their daily business. The thing is though, 13 years he'd been doing this, and 1 year he decided to stay a little bit longer. They were about to go into hibernation, and that's a time when you leave because bears get hungry. Whereas all the other times seemed to be bears would just put up with you. But this guy thought that he had an understanding with the bears and that he was one with them. That 1 year he stayed a little bit longer, he got killed. He deliberately set up his tent in a place where it was high traffic area for grizzly bears, and just one night a bear came up to his tent and was like, yeah, I'm hungry, I'm gonna eat you. And that's what these are. This one shark that was a little bit more docile, maybe it was nervous, maybe it hadn't seen a boat before, or God knows what, maybe it was tired, she thought she had a relationship with it. If she jumped in, feel out the environment through their mouth, even if a great shark just tries to investigate you, it's gonna accidentally probably end up maiming you or killing you. I don't know, man. I don't know. Maybe it's Australians. Maybe it's just to be Australian. I'm just gonna feed a shark. Yeah, let's go for that. Anyway, guys, we're gonna end up there. Maybe we'll do more in the future. There's other things that I gotta react to or stuff like that. But I just wanted to do something a bit different. But join it. Leave a like. Until next time, I'll see you later. Oh, bye-bye.